and welcome to Koi Channel. In this episode, we will start exploring another batch of fossil samples. We have 6 capsules filled with microfossils from various locations. Lots of fun for me and for you if you care to join the party. Let's begin with Holts Summit, an upper Devonian locality in the beautiful state of Missouri. The tiny fossils were chemically extracted from the Grassy Creek Shale. The rocks were treated with 10% formic acid and so-called insoluble residue was collected. The quartz crystals dominate the content of the capsule, and the black particles are almost exclusively the fragments of tooth-like fossils called conodonts. They consist of phosphate minerals. Note that formic acid should be buffered with calcium phosphate and calcium carbonate for better preservation of these fossils. When I saw the sample, it became immediately clear to me that the fossils mixed into the sand were minute and impossible to film with a regular video recorder. Fortunately, a friendly scientist came to my rescue and did some experimentation using more sophisticated equipment. He tried high magnification with transmitted light, then with a polarized light. Quartz crystals turned out spectacularly, but not the fossils. Phase contrast did not work either. Fluorescence images looked interesting. An optical sectioning in green fluorescence mode allowed for 3D rendering. We also found tiny crystals formed on the surface of the fossil, probably in the process of fossilization, creating a curious artifact. Anyway, these still images were not enough for me. More action was needed. Fortunately, my dad remembered an old trick. When you take an ocular lens from the eyepiece of practically any microscope, flip it over, press to your eye, and bring the object you want to see very close to the other side of the lens. A great way to inspect the old coins or look for microfossils. What we did next was the typical duct tape solution. We taped the lens to the digital video recorder and it worked nicely. I hope this little invention will be useful for other people who love to explore micro world. So please share this video. Just remember to be patient when you try this approach. It may take a little bit of time until you will find the right combination of the camera zoom and the distance to the object in order to allow the autofocus to do the job. Securing the camera on the tripod helps to maintain the right distance to the object. We put the fossils on a piece of regular white paper, and you can see the fibers it was made of. It also speaks of how small the fossils are. These conodonts are like flakes and are rarely more than 1 millimeter in size. Even though the conodonts are very useful for dating the rocks and often serve as index fossils, they were like a hot potato for paleontologists dealing with classification of extinct organisms. The scientists studying vertebrates called them invertebrates, and specialists in invertebrates did not want to adopt them like their own either. The current view is that conodonts were primitive chordates with soft, elongated, worm-like bodies, relatively large eyes, and possibly a short lifespan. As suggested by one recent study done for a certain group of conodonts, they lived for about a month on average, but we can't exclude that they were preyed upon. Problematic classification of conodonts leaves lots of room for all sorts of ideas. Could they have been parasites or juvenile life forms similar to tadpoles? Nobody knows for sure. The official name of these fossils is conodont elements, and it seems that certain differently shaped elements belong to the same animals. The strong argument for it, in my view, would be the fact that the elements exist in the form of symmetrical right and left versions. This makes them likely to be part of an apparatus of an animal with a bilateral symmetry. The sets of conodont elements found together are called assemblages, and scientists are trying hard to figure out how these assemblages functioned. Conodont, by the way, means cone-like tooth. Conodonts first appeared around 500 million years ago and were thriving for 300 million years, leaving behind abundant fossil records in the form of thousands upon thousands of microscopic parts. Such an early time of appearance should help to exclude many potential versions about biology of the conodont-bearing animals, also called conodontophora. They were likely feeding on something available 500 million years ago. Definitely not trilobites, because no obvious sign of wear was found on the conodonts, suggesting that what they eat was soft, like jellyfish or comb jellies, for example. I can imagine a conodontophora grabbing a jellyfish with the long, spear-like elements and munching on it with shorter knife or saw-like elements. Anyway, thanks for watching and stay tuned because the next time we might talk about what happens when fossils like conodonts get baked and what it has to do with oil explorations. Until that time, good luck on your trails and stay safe. Bye-bye now!